Hey guys, it's Lachlan from Lachlan Likes a Thing, and I'm at my university and we're having another little headphone meet. So I have a chance to do an ABX test with some friends, and we're going to be testing the assertion that 128K AAC is transparent compared to the original lossless file. So we're going to be doing the blind ABX testing in FUBAR 2000 with 10 trials each. We're going to use the AAC conversion in the latest version of version 11 of iTunes. The laptop is in flight mode, so all the wireless antennas are turned off. We are using WASAPI output in FUBAR 2000. We are using a Headroom Pico DAC and a V100 Vioelectric amp. And I'm just going to ask the guys to choose a headphone of their choice to use with the amp and a track of their choice. So let's get right to it. So our first victim is going to be Shane. And Shane, which headphone are you going to use to do the ABX test in?
Probably the 650.
The 650, can you actually show us the headphone? Thank you.
Sennheiser HD650.
And then, and what track have you chosen to do the ABX test with?
Chris Bodie, When Rain Falls.
What do you think your chances are going to be?
Very slim.
Very slim.
Next to none.
Even for 128K AAC, you think your chances are going to be very slim?
Yep.
Okay. All right. Okay, so we're going to start 10 trials.
Okay.
Starting now. So Shane is stuck on the first trial here.
Justifying my ego.
Shane is having real trouble differentiating between the two tracks that he knows are actually lossless and lossy. I would actually not use an open. I think Shane is actually not able to do this test at the moment because it's an open headphone. Are you finding it difficult because it's open?
We could try a closed one.
So Shane is finding it very difficult to do this test with the Sennheiser HD650. So he's going to switch to a closed back headphone to see if this makes any difference. And he's using the Audio Technica W10VTG.
Use this? Really?
But they're vintage. So while Shane is taking his time, have you done the first trial yet?
Yes.
AAC. That's not even half what iTunes is twice that bitrate.
Alright, my ears are hurting. It's really
okay.
Loud.
All right, everyone, the moment of truth. Are you ready to see your result?
Yeah, okay.
For your 10 trials. How do you think you did?
Really poorly.
Really poorly. So remember, Shane has to get 9 out of 10 for us to be able to statistically say that
9 out of 10
yeah. For us to be 98.9% confident that he can differentiate between 128K AAC
and
a flat lossless file. So let's unhide the results. And the result is that you got 5 out of 10, which means the probability that you are randomly guessing is 62.3%.
That's pretty much on par.
Awesome. Okay, who's next?
Who's next?
Okay, so our next challenger is Thomas. And he is going to be using which headphone to do the ABX test with?
So I'll be trying with my favorite AKG K701.
Now, which track have you chosen?
I've chosen track 3 of the Howl's Moving Castle soundtrack.
Awesome.
Stroll Through the Air.
And how do you think you're going to do on this test, Thomas? Have you ever done an ABX test before?
Yes and no. Nothing very controlled. So, and I've also been using MP3s instead of AAC, so I don't know how the sound profile will be different and whether it's better it is a newer format. So, I don't know.
Well, we're gonna find out.
I'm already starting to feel nervous about the fact that these are open band. Because I can hear everything.
Yeah, that's I would not do this on open band. Okay, so Thomas is doing the ABX test again with the Fit Ear MH334. And because we want to go fully battery powered, because you can actually hear the buzz from the amp, from the power supply, because of those in ears, we're actually going to switch to the Objective 2 with the ODAC, and this is completely battery powered, so we are completely isolated from mains power at the moment. So, Thomas, go ahead.
Did I tell you I was doing the ABX test last night until 12 o'clock and then I dreamt about doing ABX tests when I went to sleep and it was terrible.
I was trying to time this one little bit, and this is the clunkiest interface.
It is. How many tries have you done?
Two. Yeah.
Two. Keep it one, I think you need to do it faster.
Oh. I don't think I can hear a difference. Would you like me to just guess the rest? Like, nil confidence at all. Maybe it is. I feel like these earphones were poorly suited to it.
Alright. Okay, alright.
50-50.
Moment of truth. Moment of truth for Thomas with the MH3V4s. How do you think you did, Thomas?
Abysmal.
Abysmal. Okay. Alright, and remember, Thomas needs to get 9 out of 10 to get a scientifically valid result. So, his results are 8 out of 10.
What?
Which gives him a 94.5% probability that he did not randomly guess. But did you randomly guess, Thomas?
No.
Your heart of hearts.
No, but guess? I didn't have any confidence in it.
No, but did you hear any differences?
No.
The sound stage was like a tiny bit, but it was so hard to tell.
That's interesting. So there you go. 8 out of 10
I'm
is just one short of being
genuinely surprised.
95%. Actually, if it's 5.5%, you're 0.5% away from 95% confidence. So that's pretty good. It does appear as though you were able to discern some kind of difference.
Maybe if you try it again, you get 5.
No, it's exhausting to do this.
Yeah. It...
Okay, so Josh is our next challenger. Josh, what are you using for your plan of choice?
I'll be using the Unique Melody Miracles. Custom IEMs.
All right. So, closed. Good idea. Yep. We're actually going to be, again, using the Objective 2 with the ODAC just to be on battery power. And what track have you chosen?
I have actually chosen Platinum Disco by Iguchi Yuka. Please don't judge me.
Okay. All right. Any particular reason why you chose this track?
Sorry?
Any particular reason why you chose this track?
Because I know it well, basically.
That's the best way. Okay, so have you ever done any ABX tests before?
Not in a controlled environment.
Okay. And how do you think your chances of success will go?
Not very well. I'll pretty much be guessing because A, my hearing is terrible, and B's IEMs tend to be fairly forgiving of poorly mastered material.
All right, we'll see.
Okay, finish trial one.
Okay, trial one. How did you feel? Did you hear any difference between file A and file B?
Not really, not much.
Except I bet my
okay,
this
so
is worrying.
Or do you had some sort of logic behind your choice?
I think there is a small difference. I could be second guessing myself in the drum beats. They sounded a little bit tinnier on the AAC file, I think. But that remains to be seen whether or not I can tell the difference.
All right, well, let's keep going.
Okay.
Okay.
Next trial, six.
Number six. Are you speeding up because you're starting to guess, or are you speeding up because you can, you've worked out how to tell the difference?
Yeah, I know. I'm not talking about
J. I really think I'm starting to guess at this stage. The more I listen, the more the same the song each file sounds.
Okay.
I don't know how
that
works.
So you're getting tired.
Maybe.
Okay, so you have actually completed the trials. Josh has completed his 10 trials.
Can I look now?
Yeah, you can look now. I haven't... So Josh, how do you think you did?
Terribly.
Terribly. Okay, well, are you going to guess a number?
4?
Okay. So, again, Josh needs to get 9 out of 10 to for us to be confident that he can tell a difference between these two files. And the result he got was... 4 out of 10.
At least
you guessed
right
that correctly.
That. Yes.
So that gives us a 82% probability that Josh was guessing randomly. And did you start guessing randomly at some point?
Yeah, the more, like I said, the more I listened, the more similar the tracks sounded, so...
Does this make you feel any different about AAC files?
I never really had an opinion about AAC files to begin with. But, you know, I think part of it might be due to equipment. You know, perhaps, you know, more analytical equipment, you know, earphones or IEMs would allow you to detect that difference. Yeah, my mind is still open.
Awesome. Okay. All right. Well, thank you, Josh.
Thank you.
And I'm not going to be able to do any more trials at the moment, but I thought this was a pretty interesting test. We wanted to test whether 128K AAC was indistinguishable from the original lossless source, and we kind of had mixed results. Thomas seemed to have a result that was quite good. It wasn't past the 95% confidence level, but Josh and Shane didn't do so well. And, you know, I would say from this test that if it's this difficult to discern 128K AAC from lossless files, 256K AAC at twice the bitrate, which is what iTunes offers, is probably a pretty high quality option. Anyway, thanks for watching. You can talk to me on Facebook at facebook.com/locklikesathing or on Twitter @locklikesathing. Click the like button if you enjoyed this video, and happy listening.